obsequium pauperum, awareness, willingness, and service of the poor. A poverty which, in the oldest sense of the word, means the absence of something important and essential. In this sense, there's no form of need more absolute and painful than that of the sick person, the person suffering from poor health, the sick person of any era, race, or belief. They're the people the Knights of Malta have been serving for 9 centuries, from the Holy Land to the Mediterranean, and then later from their new center of operations in Italy, reaching out towards an ever-changing world. The order has also changed, but to a lesser degree. The doctor's white coat has replaced the knight's chain mail, but the 8-pointed cross is still there. It symbolizes the perennial modernity of a mission that spans time and that will always have meaning as long as there's a human being who suffers. The great tradition of the Order of Malta's charity work is renewed daily in its hospitals, clinics and welfare centers in over 120 countries through the commitment of its 12,000 members, 80,000 permanent volunteers, 11,000 doctors and paramedics, through the initiatives of its 10 priories and 46 national associations. And again, with the work of Malteser International, the relief corps which for half a century has been addressing great emergencies, natural disasters, epidemics or armed conflicts. Routine or extraordinary, the mission never changes, nor do its beneficiaries, the aged, the disabled, refugees, the homeless, the terminally ill, lepers, children, or drug addicts. Many faces, but with a single outstretched hand. Within the closely woven fabric of the Order's humanitarian structures gleams a precious stone, the Maternity Hospital in Bethlehem. The hospital stands in the land that was the cradle of Christianity, where the first hospitalers of the Middle Ages dedicated their lives to what they fittingly called Our Lords of the Sick, in a part of the world which is currently a crossroads of strained relations and bloody conflicts. The Order has cultivated an oasis of life and hope, where expectant mothers of every religion find care and comfort, and where over 35,000 children have been born since 1990. In other parts of the world, Africa and Southeast Asia especially, the Order has taken up the challenge of consigning the ancient but now curable disease of leprosy to the history books. The lengthy list continues. In France, Ecuador, Lebanon and Hungary, many volunteers of the Order of Malta devote themselves to the disabled. In the United States, Chile, Mexico and various European countries, the Order runs establishments to assist the aged. In Latin America, its activities are aimed at children living in the slums, at single mothers and problematic youth. In Europe, and especially in French-speaking countries, it works with drug addicts and the homeless. Around these specialized centers is a great belt of hospitals and clinics scattered around the 4 cardinal points, from Lebanon to Peru, from Poland to South Africa. It's an unfailing commitment in the first as in the third world, not even when there's a sudden and extraordinary crisis. The traditional activity of helping refugees and victims of conflicts, which kept the Order so busy during the 2 world wars, continues in the many dramatic scenarios of our own time. From the crisis of the Great Lakes region in Africa to the Balkans, from Lebanon to El Salvador and Vietnam, and more recently in Iraq, in post-Taliban Afghanistan and in the Darfur region of the Sudan, which is threatened by genocide. The Order has also been present in the Asian regions affected by the tsunami, in Pakistan after the earthquake there, and in New Orleans following Hurricane Katrina. Places marked by suffering and sadness, where the Order's volunteers patiently plant the seeds for a new future. From the world for the world. The prerogatives of a sovereign subject and its international character guarantee the continuity of the Order's vocation. The Order of Malta enjoys special ties with Italy, which welcomed it as an exile from Malta 170 years ago and allowed it to establish 2 extraterritorial government seats in Rome. It's a special relationship that's been cultivated over time, resulting in intense and fruitful partnerships that are still producing results, as demonstrated by the joint humanitarian projects that the Order is currently organizing with the Italian government and civil defense for Equatorial Guinea and Southern Sudan. A long tradition of friendship which explains the particular dynamism of the Order's Italian organizations. Assigned as auxiliary of the Italian army since the early years of national unity during the First and Second World Wars, the Order of Malta's military corps performed invaluable work in defending human life. With its first aid stations, field hospitals, and above all, its famous hospital trains. During the most dramatic scenarios of the two wars, from Caporetto to the Russian campaign, the wagons emblazoned with the eight-pointed cross transported thousands of wounded soldiers from the battlefront to the local hospitals. Their lives were often saved at the last minute thanks to delicate surgical operations carried out under the rattle of artillery fire and the clatter of the rails. The Order of Malta's soldiers have been equally active in peacetime too. They've come to the rescue during natural disasters like the floods in the Po Valley or the earthquakes in Irpinia, Bellice, Friuli and Messina, up to the latest one in 2002, which struck San Giuliano in Puglia. The Order flanks the activities of its uniformed soldiers with that of its doctors, hospitals, clinics and specialized centers. Like the diabetes units, which can be found all over Italy, or the Hospital of St. John the Baptist, a national point of reference for neuro-rehabilitation and stroke victims. Situated in the Roman district of Magliana, this prestigious establishment includes a famous school for nurses, a place for healing and learning, where cutting-edge techniques exist alongside the ethics and professionalism of the oldest hospitaler tradition in the world. The Order's Italian First Aid Corps completes this hospitaler activity. The mass media often focus on these adults and young people, women and men, industrious and vigilant during particularly significant moments of public life. For example, they were there to assist the thousands of people from all over Italy and the world who poured into St. Peter's Square for the last emotional farewell to John Paul II in April 2005. Serving humanity in its fragility and upholding its dignity. This great ideal needs a solid foundation in order to flourish. The foundation is guaranteed by the institutional sovereignty of the Order of Malta, the indispensable background for its humanitarian mission. An intense diplomatic activity with 94 countries, representation at the United Nations and major international organizations are not just expressions of empty formality, they are the lifeblood of an international prestige which guarantees dedication and trustworthiness. It's this dependability which smooths the way for the ambulances with the Maltese Cross in war zones, which gives organizations and governments the confidence to finance projects sponsored by the Order, and which enables the Knights of Malta to be faithful to themselves and their mission. For its assistance in making this possible, the great family of the Order of Malta extends its heartfelt gratitude to Italy, the country that welcomed the Order's establishments so generously and that enables this ancient institution to maintain its independence and sovereignty. Not to be enjoyed by a few, but to be at the service of all.